Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi WordPress theme tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignerTechTips.com. Well, we've got a little experimental site here that we're demoing on. What we're going to do in this video, let's create some custom call to action buttons, or custom buttons, if you will. We're not going to use their button modules. Let's make our own and see if we can't get something interesting going. Divi is absolutely awesome, just keeps getting better and better. If you're building any sort of WordPress site at all, I would recommend you take a look at it. You can check it out and demo below this video here. So let's get started. I've got Divi installed here. We're logged in. I'm going to enable the Visual Builder. Now we've got that going. Let's add a section. I'm going to hit this little blue button, add a new section, left click. I'm going to make it a regular section. And what I want is, I kind of want a button fair size in the middle here. So I'm going to choose three columns here. And we're just going to use the middle one. Obviously, you do it how you want to do it. And inside this middle one here, I'm going to add a text module, just a regular text module. So I'll just scroll down, left click on the text module. There we go. Okay. Don't need any of that. We want to put in what we want it to say in our button. So let's say special deals. I don't know. And something like reach out. Let's make this one heading 4. Obviously, you make yours how you want to. I'm just going to demo this the best as I can, and we'll make this one heading 3. Okay, so that looks really exciting, doesn't it? Just a little text module there. So let's go and start making it a little more interesting. So we're still on our content tab. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go to background, and we'll give it a background color or a background gradient or a background image. Probably not going to use a video. Let's give it a gradient. Okay. Make the colors a little more interesting. Have a dark blue on the top, perhaps. And a bit lighter blue on the bottom. Let's flip it around and have it horizontal. The gradient orientation here, 180, it's top to bottom. Give it 90 degrees so it'll go left to right. There we go. I think that dark blue is a little too. In keeping with our rest of the things we got here. Of course, you can paste in whatever colors you want here also. There we are, let's do something like that. Okay, so we've got a background color for it. Can't really see that text, so let's fix that next. Let's go to our design tab, left click on it. Remember I made one of those 4 and 1 3, I can't remember which is which. So we'll go to heading 4. Let's make it white so it stands out. That was that top one. And make it bold as well. Let's make it ultra bold. Special deals. Anything else we want to do here? We could, well, text size wise, I think that's okay. I don't really want any box shadow on it. I don't think I need it. Could try it. Not going to make that much difference. Well, that kind of stands out a little bit. So I'm fairly happy with that. And we could transform it so it's capitals. Yeah, that stands out pretty well. And let's do the one below that, which was heading 3, I believe. And we'll also make that white, or you can make it yellow, whatever color stands out for you. That looks a bit weird to me, so let's put it white again. Again, do I want it? I think that's fine. Could make it slightly bolder. Semi-bold? Yeah, that stands out nicely. Okay, well, that's working, but probably want it center aligned and want to give it a bit of breathing room. So let's do that next. I think we can go down to here and center align that. And the same for number 4, heading 4, top one. That's great. Now we want to give him a bit of space. Let's go to design again. And this time we'll close that heading 1. And we want to go down to close the heading and go down to spacing. And we're going to use padding, don't need a margin because that'll push the whole thing up and down, left and right, wherever. Let's say, let's click that so they're both the same. Let's give it, I don't know, 25 top and bottom. Yep, that gives it a bit more space. And we're okay left and right, but I'll give it padding left and right anyway, because it may change on smaller devices. Again, let's click the link, so I just have to put it in once. Yeah, that's fine. You didn't see any actual change there. Special deal stands out. Try a little bit of box shadow on that H3 there. Let's go back to our text, our heading text. This may not work. Let's just try it. Yeah, that's fine. Let's do that. Okay, so we've got a gradient background going on there. Our text is standing out nicely. Let's perhaps give this some rounded corners. So let's close up this module one more time. Go down to border. And to make it really rounded, you can just do a few. If you just want slightly rounded corners, you see that's gone slightly round. Actually, that's not too bad, but I want something a little more bold than that. So let's give it 50 pixels, and that should make it sort of very rounded. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. So that's good. We've got our initial sort of button here, but it doesn't actually do anything. But we'll deal with that in a moment. Now, Divi brought in some great features, some hover features, that you can make things do things on hover. So if we go down a box shadow here, let's select this inner one right here. Now it's brought that around there. Now, if you go up, to the actual box shadow, horizontal position, vertical position, you'll see these little arrows appear. And if you click on those, it'll give you the option to have a different one when it hovers. So on the default, at the moment it's 10. Set that to 0. So I really don't want anything on the default. So and we'll set that one to 0. And as you can see, it's not there. And when it hovers, I want something that sort of comes all the way across. So click on the hover tab there. And let's have a look, see. You see it building as I'm doing this? Okay, well, we want it further than 80. That's probably it's probably almost around 300 pixels. So let's try 300. Almost there. If you wanted to, you could leave a little ditty there if you wanted to, but I'm going to have it all the way. So let's add, say, perhaps another 20. Yeah, that's fine. So if we look on the default, there's no shadow. On the hover, there's a full shadow. Let's actually make that color stand out a bit better. I might also make that special deal slightly bigger, I don't know. So we've got our box shadow. Let's go down to the color. Oh, purple, let's make it purple, how's that? Well, that's pretty eye-catching, isn't it? Okay, let's put a custom color in. What about something like that? Something that's going to stand out from the original for sure. That's fine. If you want it to mix with the color, you can just bring the opacity down a little bit. But we want it to stand out. I'm going to take the opacity back to zero. And let's scroll back up. That's the hover state. That's the regular state. Yeah, so that stands out pretty well. Fairly pleased with that. Think, like I said, I want to make that special, which is the heading 4, a bit bigger. So you can, when I hover over it, you've got these little paintbrush icon things. You can just click on it if you want to, and it'll take you straight to there, H4, which is kind of handy. Now, here's the text size. It's 18. If we make it 24. Yeah, that's a bit better, isn't it? I'm happy with that. Okay, so we've got our button, but it doesn't do anything. It's just a pretty little round button there, or not pretty if you don't like it. And as I say, use your own styles. Don't just copy what I'm doing here. So we want it to actually do something. Let's go back to the content tab, and you can click on a link here. Now, you can either link it to an external URL, just paste your URL, another page, or wherever you want to go. So I'm just going to save that before I put it in there, because I'm not sure where I want it to go yet. I think I might like it to go down. Here we've got some sale items. Let's have it to go down here. And to have it go down here, we've got to give this section a CSS ID, because it has no URL. It's the same URL as the rest of the page. So let's click on that section's little cog, get in there. Let's go over to the Advanced tab, CSS ID and Classes. Now we want to give it an ID, not a class, an ID. Whatever you want, I guess we'll call it Specials, as that's what we've called the button there. So it's now got an ID of Specials. Just save that. Go back up to our button here and click on our little edit cog. Now if we go to the content, let's go down to link. Now it's an ID. To get to a CSS ID, you want to use a hashtag, and the name of the ID was Specials, S-P-E-C-I-A-L-S. Wants to open in the same window because it's on the same page. So that's pretty irrelevant, that part right there. Okay, so now that should be an active link that will take us down to those little sale items there. Anything else we want to do? Let's give it a little animation on load. So if we go back to the design tab, animation. What about if we have it flip? Yeah, why not? Just once. Duration. Bring the duration up just slightly. I don't know, 1500, something like that, 16. Don't need to spend a lot of time on it. Right, well, I think we're there, so let's save that. Let's save our changes. A little purple button down the bottom here. Click on it, go over to the right, and save our changes. If you forget to do that and you go up and exit the Visual Builder, it will prompt you to save your changes, which is good because I forget stuff all the time. So let's exit the Visual Builder. And see what we've got. Scroll down. Make sure our effect's working. Let's just reload that. Yeah, there's that little spin effect. And when we hover over it, we've got that little purple deal going on there. Make it stand out. Now, hopefully, when we click on it, it should take us straight down to those sale items. There we are, taking us straight there. Let's check that out one more time. And that is pretty eye-catching. You can do anything you want because we're making you're making your own there. And like I say, don't just use what I've got here. Make your own deal up. Now, if you wanted to, we could go a lot further. I'm not going to today. I'll finish this video. You could use custom CSS to make it do all kind of different things if you wanted to, like we've done in previous videos. So there you have it. There is how to make custom buttons or a custom button idea for your Divi WordPress theme. I hope you've enjoyed that and found it useful. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like I said, you can try out Divi from a link below this video. It really is awesome. If you're building WordPress sites, do check it out. If you're interested in web development, we've got a bunch of courses below. There's some great free courses as well as some premium courses. And we've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.